Hello guys, welcome back. So today I'm going to talk about like how to build and deploy Spring Boot with MongoDB application on AWS EC2 instance. Okay, so this is my application. So it will perform like CRUD operations. I have like add employees and updated and deleted employees information. So in this controller. So I have an application.aml file. I have like Spring data, MongoDB, URI. Okay, so I will explain like how this URI will look like and what are the information we need to give here. And let me open this AWS homepage. So open this and click on this services EC2 instance. So right now I don't have any running instances. Let me create one instance, guys. So these are the terminated instance, you can just ignore. So click on launch instance. Okay, EC2 running instances, launch instance. So I'm going to choose this Linux machine. Okay, so you can choose like depends on your requirement. So click on select. So I'm going to choose this free tier. So configure instance details. So number of instances, so one is enough for me. Like if you want like more instances, you can mention here. Add storage. So we have like 30 GB, okay, free here, but the size is 8 GB. That's fine for me. Okay, so add tags. So let me add name here, Spring Demo. Okay, and configure security group. So I'm going to take all traffic, so which will access from anywhere. Okay, so this is not a recommended way, so don't use this security group. So for demo purpose I'm taking this one. So review and launch. So these are the instance type and security groups information. You can just make sure that, so before you are going to launch this instance, so click on launch. So if you are already have like key pair, okay, security key pair, so you can use that, but I'm going to create the new one. So create new pair. So I'm going to take Spring, so demo. So download key pair. So it's downloaded successfully. Click on launch instance. Okay, it will take like couple of minutes to start this EC2 instance. So click on this view instances. So the status it is showing as pending. Okay, so in the meantime, so I'm going to check S3 bucket, because we need S3 bucket to get this jar file inside this EC2 instance. So click on S3. So already I have a S3 bucket here, but I don't have any file inside this S3 bucket. Okay, I'm going to upload that Spring Boot application jar file inside this S3 bucket to get inside the EC2 instance. Okay, that's it, guys. So let me open this EC2 instance. So let me check the status of this instance. So once it is running, okay, it's running. Okay, the status is running. So click on this. So this is the public DNS. Okay, and click on connect. Okay, so if you are using Windows machine, you can use the PuTTY to connect this EC2 instance, but I'm using Mac OS. That is the reason like I'm using Mac terminal. So let me maximize this terminal, guys. So I'm going to change this file permission. Okay, change mode 400. Okay, it's not available. Let me navigate to that path, so which is available in downloads. Okay, let me paste this. Yeah, so I'm going to connect through this SSH command. Okay, so let me paste this and let's connect this. So yes, that's connected successfully. And let me check the Java version. Okay, So 1.7, but we need a Java 1.8. So let me install Java 1.8. Okay, so basically we have a yum. So by using yum we can download 1.8. So that is sudo yum install Java 1.8 command. So it will take like couple of seconds. And let me run Java and Java C commands once it is installed. So it's installed successfully. So Java command and Java C command. Okay, so I will add this gels in the description so you can get it from there. Okay, let me create this. So now you can check Java version. So we have 1.8 here. So it's added successfully, guys. Okay, so now I'm going to install MongoDB inside this EC2 instance. Okay, so I'm going to create one file. Okay, so let me. So I'm going to add so repository details, so MongoDB repository details. So insert, paste here. So this is the information that we need to provide inside this file. So MongoDB ORG 4.0. That is what that means is. So I'm going to install 4.0 version, MongoDB 4.0 version, and these are the base URLs for this MongoDB. Okay, so let me save this. Okay, so now I'm going to install this MongoDB by using yum. So let me copy this command and paste here. So that is sudo yum install MongoDB. Okay, it will take like a couple of seconds, guys, to install this MongoDB. So it's installed. Okay, I'm going to start the MongoDB service inside this EC2 instance. So let's start this by using sudo service mongod start. So it started successfully, and so you can check the logs. So to make sure that this MongoDB is working on 27017 port number. So it's working on 27017 port number. So this is the port number. So that's fine. And you can run like one more command to have a MongoDB start automatically on boot. Okay. So if something is went wrong, like if power is went out, and if you want to start MongoDB automatically, so you can run this command like sudo check config mongo g on. Okay, and that's it. So let me clear this and let's connect the Mongo database by using Mongo console. And I'm going to create one database, that is my employee. So the command is use my employee. Okay, and it's created. Now I'm going to create one user. Okay, so I'm going to use that user details inside my Spring Boot application. Okay, so username and the password and the roles. So the role I took is read and write role, and DB is my employee. So that's it. It's created successfully, guys. So let me exit this, and we have to configure Mongo database. Okay, so let me go to this Mongo configuration file. Let me open this console, paste here. So this is MongoDB configuration file. Okay, we have to configure. So port number and bind IP address. So this is the port number, so and the bind IP. So I'm going to modify this as let me insert. So I'm going to modify as 000. Okay, so that's it. And you can just make sure that security is enabled or not. So we don't have any security inside this MongoDB. So now I'm going to copy this. So security authorization configuration here. Okay, copy here and paste here. Yeah, so that's it guys. You can save this file, colon x, and you can restart your Mongo database to reflect these changes. Okay, so I'm going to restart this. Yeah, so it started successfully. Yeah, that's it. So now what I'm going to do is, so I'm going to take this public DNS name from this EC2 instance. So this is the public DNS, so you can copy this public DNS and you can paste in your application.yml file. So this is Spring Data MongoDB URI. So we have a username and password, so that we have created in MongoDB. Okay, so and this is our EC2 instance public DNS. You can just paste here, and this is our database, so my employee. Okay, so this database name should be matched with our MongoDB database name. Okay, so that we have created earlier. So that's it guys. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to create the jar file. So and I'm going to upload this jar file inside this S3 bucket. So let me open that S3 bucket, and I'm going to get this jar file. So inside this EC2 instance, I already have this S3 bucket. So let me open this. I'm going to upload that jar file. So see whether it's completed or not. It's completed, guys. So add files and go to that path. We have MongoDB inside target, we have jar file, and choose that jar file and click on next. So provide the public read access and next and next and upload. So to upload this, it will take like a couple of seconds, and so once it is uploaded successfully, I'm going to get this jar file inside the EC2 instance. Okay, and after that I'm going to start the server, guys, so that it's embedded Tomcat. So let's wait for this, and it's completed successfully. And click on this jar file and copy this copy link and come to this EC2 instance and wget, okay, and paste this jar, and yeah, it's successfully like downloaded this jar file inside this EC2 instance. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to start this by using jar file, okay, by using this java jar command. So copy this, okay, start this. And so our MongoDB is running on port 27017, right? So that port should be available in our EC2 instance security group. Okay, so this is started successfully. Okay, so now I'm going to add like inbound rule. So go to this EC2 instance and click on running instances. So click on this running instances, and so go to the security groups and click on launch wizard. So here we have a security rules, inbound rules and outbound rules. But so I'm going to add like inbound rules. Okay, so edit inbound rules. So I'm going to add one more rule, that is custom TCP and 27017. So that is going to access from anywhere. Okay, so you can make sure that this 27017 port is matched with your port number or not. Okay, so you can just save these rules. So that's it guys. So let me restart this. Okay, so once it is started successfully, I'm going to hit the endpoints to see like whether it's working or not. So go to this EC2 dashboard and running instances. Click on this instance and copy this public DNS name. Go to browser and /8080. So my endpoint is employees, API employees. Hit enter. So I'm getting the empty response, guys, because I don't have any data. So let me add some data by using post mapping. So we have a post URL here. I have body. So this is the data I'm going to provide here, ID and name. Okay. So click on send. Okay, something went wrong. So click on send. It's added successfully. So now hit it again, get mapping to get the employees. See this? So it's working fine, guys. So this is how like you can build and deploy Spring Boot with MongoDB application on AWS EC2 instance. Okay. So if you have, guys, like any doubts, so please let me know in the comment section. I will try to answer. Okay. Thanks for watching. Bye. Have a good day. So if you like this video, so please do like and subscribe my YouTube channel. Thanks. Bye.